If you want to get the best performance out of a slick racing tyre, it's commonplace to use some method of warming the tyre prior to fitting it to the car and heading out on track. Doing this properly gives us two advantages. First of all, the tyre tread as well as the carcass are up to operating temperature before that car heads out of the pits. This means that straight away the tyre is ready to produce optimum grip. This can also actually improve the life expectancy and reliability of the tyre. So how do we go about warming the tyres up though? Well, generally there's two techniques that are used. The first is to use a tyre warming blanket. You could think of this like an electric blanket for your tyres. These wrap around the tread of the tyre, and primarily they will heat the tread of the tyre as well as the carcass of the tyre. A good thing with the tyre warmers like this is that they do provide a lot of control. It can control the temperature of the tyre blanket, and that's important because ideally we want to be targeting a tyre temperature or tread temperature around about 80 degrees C. If we actually go too hot with the tyre temperature, this can actually end up potentially damaging the tyre. The disadvantage with tyre blankets like this though is that they don't do that much to heat up the wheel. What this means is that predominantly the heat is in the tread of the tyre and the carcass, and once the tyre is actually fitted to the car, particularly in colder temperatures, the tyre can quickly lose that temperature. The other option is the tyre oven. Now these are a little bit bigger and a little bit more infrastructure for the teams to manage. You can think of this essentially like a tent, and normally a heater such as a diesel heater is used to fire high temperature air into the tent. The tyres are then stacked inside of the tent. Now there is an advantage here because the tyres and the wheels are inside of the tent. Not only does the tyre end up hot, but the wheel rim itself, and the wheel rim then will dissipate heat into the tyre once it's fitted onto the car, so the effect can last longer. The downside is we don't have as much control with a tyre warming tent, and particularly because heat rises, we tend to find that the tyres that are at the top of the tent will become hotter. And particularly in some of these tents, if we're not managing the temperature being added into the tent carefully, it's not too difficult to end up with the top tyres overheated, which as I mentioned can potentially damage the tread. Now that's not to say that tyre warmers are essential, but if you do want to get the most out of your slick racing tyre, they can be a real advantage.
If you like that video, make sure you give it a thumbs up, and if you're not already a subscriber, make sure you're subscribed. We release a new video every week, and if you like free stuff, we've got a great deal for you. Click the link in the description to claim your free spot to our next live lesson.